And how many action sequences are there in Rocky Handsome?
In totality, I think so 9 or 10, but 7 major sequences. Yeah.
Bone crunching, no? Really bone crunching.
Hi John, this is Prachi from Dining Jagran. Is film ka naam kaise decide kiya gaya, Rocky Handsome?
Now we always have this debate who found the name, but okay. I found it.
Okay.
No, it all started that Johnny Handsome. When we saw this look, I said you look very handsome in this. So Johnny Handsome was a film way back. Then we thought Johnny becomes too direct. Like Johnny, John Abraham. So we gave it a thought 1 or 2 days, and I thought of Rocky Handsome.
Thank
we
you.
Always he always says he thought. No, I thought of it.
And for I me, it worked because Stallone. I'm a big fan of Stallone. So, but credit to Nishi. He really thought of this name, and I think it's a very catchy name. With whatever research we've done, extremely catchy.
And also it does justice to the subject, like both the names he's called in different places.
Nishi sir, here Ali from movietalkies.com. My question to you, you know, same time during the action and acting, how difficult for you same time during action and acting?
Me?
Yeah.
Acting and direction?
Yeah.
Very honestly, extremely difficult. I've never done it before. I've done separately. I've acted at, I've done my share of theatre and everything. But I've been a very pure director when it comes to directing. It is difficult, and I respect those legends who have done it before, like, you know, the greats who have been actor directors for generations and successful. The biggest problem I face is if I'm acting, I'm thinking like a director, whether the opposite actor is performing well or not, the trolley position is correct or not, the lights are correct or not. And that disturbs my performance. So I don't make justice to my own acting if I'm directing at the same time. So in fact, it was a last moment thing that I had to act in the film. Ideally, I will not direct myself as an actor. I will try and avoid it. Yeah, separately I might act, or separately I might direct, but not together.
But same time, don't even look like, who decides the look, they're totally like bored, you know?
So he's a director, he decides everything.
No, actually, Teddy plays my younger brother. Teddy, just get up, no? See, this is how he looks. So,
Teddy, come on stage, yeah.
So, it is like a tale of two brothers. So, I had to look like his brother. And the best way was to get tonsured. No, actually, I had just thought of it 2-3 days before when I kept on looking at Teddy. And I said, how will I look like his brother? So the idea came off, and then yes, my assistants made it a point that I stay tonsured for 1-1.5 years. So they kept on, yeah. After every 3 months, they would have a schedule saying that, no, now you'll have to do takla again. They kept me busy with that. Thank you for that.
Okay, lastly, now you're more focused in direction and acting because you're famous in, I think now, villain also. So.
No. Direction will always remain first love. That always remains.
John, this is Nandeep from DNA. I have a question to both of you. You guys have gifted us Force, which redefined action in Bollywood. There's a recall value to that film. Also, people expect a lot from you guys, both as a pair. So, do you think it will be an advantage or a disadvantage for Rocky Handsome, or both?
I think I can only see it being an advantage. It's because Nayandeep, we've actually taken the film, honestly, we've taken it to another level. I wouldn't just say it. You've seen the trailer. You've seen what we've done here. And what we do is we benchmark our films against our last films only. That's the best way of doing it. And I think this is completely taken to another level.
Obviously, the collaboration of me and him and Force behind us helps Rocky Handsome. It's definitely an advantage when it comes to release. But we, as individuals, we had a much higher responsibility that if we've created some sort of a name as a team, then we have to take it to the next level. In fact, it was in a way disadvantage for us in the sense while working that we had to constantly remind ourselves that it has to be way better than Force or our earlier collaboration. But yes, it definitely helps for the film that we are working together again.
You know, one more question. Marketing and promotions are an integral part of filmmaking today. This film has been marketed really intelligently. You know, there's a teaser coming out, then the songs, then the trailer. Whose plan was it, and how creatively are you involved, John, in the marketing campaign? Like, releasing it 3 weeks prior to the...
I think, see, that's a very good question. I'll tell you, first of all, I'll give credit to Digi Osmosis, which is doing our digital campaign, Spot On, which is doing our on-ground campaign, and Parag and our entire PR team. But outside of that, Rahul Nanda is someone who has been very instrumental in actually making this happen. He's been a think tank, and outside of that, I think Sunir and his entire team with Nishi and me, we've actually, each one of us has been completely involved. Because if you see, this is not a multi-starer. This is just three or four of us sitting here. So each one of us has taken every little photograph into account, saying 3 weeks pehle ye release hona chahiye, uske baad 2 weeks pehle ya 3 days pehle ye release hona chahiye, 2 days pehle ye. So even if you see the trailer launch, everything has been, every little thing has been taken into account. So we've actually been very careful with the marketing, but we've also been very honest with the film. We've not tried to show another film that it is. This is Rocky Handsome. This is what you're going to get, and please come and watch it.
Nishikant sir, aapke right idhar. मैं ईटीवी से रितेश हूँ.
एक्चुअली जस्ट वन सेकंड अपॉलोजीज. जस्ट राइट स्टूडियोज हुज डन विजुअल प्रमोशंस हैज अ बिग हैंड इन द वे आर वेरियस थिंग्स आर लुकिंग ऑन द ऑडियो विजुअल फॉर्म.
या मनीष, आई थिंक फैंटास्टिक. आई जस्ट गिव हिम अ बिग हग टुडे फॉर अ फैंटास्टिक प्रेजेंटेशन.
सर आपसे सवाल है कि जब ये कैरेक्टर लिखे जा रहे थे तभी से आपका डिसाइड था कि आप ही विलेन बनेंगे, कोई और भी दिमाग में था?
वेरी ऑनेस्टली नहीं था, मैंने सोचा भी नहीं था कि मैं विलन का किरदार करूँगा. इनफैक्ट हमारे मेरे एक बहुत करीबी दोस्त हैं जो एक्टर नहीं है, लेकिन उनका फेस बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग था, तो मैं उनके पीछे पड़ा था कि आप ये रोल करो. तो बोलता हाँ मैं सोचता हूँ ये वो, थोड़ा क्या है कि रोल मैं वो बोलता मैंने एक्टिंग कभी की नहीं, बोलता मैं संभाल लूँगा, सिर्फ आप ये रोल करो क्योंकि आपका फेस बहुत इंटरेस्टिंग है. करते करते शूटिंग का दौर आ गया, शूटिंग स्टार्ट हो गई, और वो लास्ट मोमेंट पे बोला मैं नहीं कर सकता, वो थोड़ा सा ये हो गया. दोस्त है मेरा बहुत करीबी, तो जब 2 दिन रह गए थे तब तक कास्टिंग हुई नहीं थी, और जॉन सर की डेटें थी हमारे पास, मतलब सारे एक्टर्स की डेट्स थी, तो वी कुडंट चेंज द स्केड्यूल, एंड इट वॉज अ थॉट के क्या करें. एंड इनफैक्ट मी एंड माई डायरेक्शन डिपार्टमेंट, हमने सोचा ये रिस्क ले गया, और दे ऑल्सो सेट के आपको कर लेना चाहिए. एंड आई जस्ट गॉट टू थ्री डेज टू प्रिपेयर द लुक, बट आई ऑलवेज न्यू द कैरेक्टर बिकॉज क्योंकि मैंने लिखा हुआ था किरदार, तो मुझे किरदार पता था, लेकिन वो कैसे दिखेगा कैसे चलेगा ये मुझे तकरीबन 2-3 दिन में मिले, एंड वी इमीडिएटली स्टार्टेड शूट.
जॉन आपकी बॉन्डिंग कैसी रही एज अ डायरेक्टर, आपको पहले डायरेक्ट करते थे और अब आप को स्टार एज अ वर्क कर रहे थे?
आई थिंक इट्स अमेजिंग क्योंकि निशि के साथ, निशि जब भी मुझे ब्रीफ करने आता है सेट पे बिफोर द शॉट, वो मुझे देखता है एंड आई लुक एट हिम एंड ही सेज यू गॉट इट नो, आई से हाँ आई गॉट इट. सो इट्स हम लोग दोनों ऑटो पायलट पे, रियली आई थिंक इट्स अ ब्यूटिफुल रिलेशनशिप, और मैं मानता हूँ कि देर आर फ्यू रिलेशनशिप्स दैट आर वेरी स्पेशल, और उनमें से देर इज अ डायरेक्टर एक्टर रिलेशनशिप, जब भी उनका एक रिलेशनशिप बनता है आई थिंक इज वेरी स्पेशल, और निशि और मेरा ये रिलेशनशिप बन चुका है, और मैं काफ़ी एक्चुअली मैं डरता हूँ कि वो भाग जाएगा कहीं पे ऐसे, निशि लेट्स डू समथिंग. So I'm always I'm a big fan of his Dombivli Fast, Mumbai Meri Jaan, Lai Bhari Jo, Drishyam, jitni sari force, of course our film together, you see every film of his. I think Nishi is honestly marketing karne ki zarurat nahi hai, aap log film dekhte ho, he's a fantastic director, so I think he's got out something really special even in Rocky Handsome.
John. John, you said you're a big fan of Sylvester Stallone. A whole lot of people were rooting for him at the Oscars this time. Were you also disappointed when he missed out?
I honestly, I was in Abu Dhabi. I didn't really follow the Oscars. But yeah, you know, when you really like somebody, you expect him to win. It's as simple as that. And he's like an underdog all the time. And Johnny Abraham is an underdog.
We also hear that there is some trouble with the censor board in getting them to give you an US certificate. So
no, there was no trouble. Okay. We went to the censors, we asked for UA. They said, I think we should go with a. We respected them. We took.
You're happy with that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Is it also true that this movie is inspired from a Korean film called Man from Nowhere?
It's actually an official remake of a Korean film called The Man from Nowhere.
It's official, huh?
It's official. But we have an Indian adaptation because when you Indianize a story which you pick up from a foreign culture, you need to adapt it to suit the sensibilities of the local audience. So, for all who've seen the original film, it comes in three shades. There is dark blue, there is black, and there is blue-black. But our film, you've seen the trailer and you've seen the visuals. Visually, it is different, and there are elements which have been brought in to adapt the film to our sensibilities, audience sensibilities.